I am starving. Okay, guys, I actually filmed this in two separate days, so I did not heat those up. So yeah, sorry it's been a little while. It's midterms week, so I've been busy grinding and studying for the past few days. I'm trying to do really well in these midterms. Last semester I took an L, but this semester we bouncing back. So yeah, now that I finished most of my exams, so I thought I'd make a quick video talking about the tips and strategies that I use, what helps me focus, things like that. So let's get to it. Alright, so first off and most importantly, you have to be in the right state of mind. You have to be focused, mentally prepared, and just not have any distractions getting in your way of you really focusing and getting prepared for your exams. Whether it's a quiz, whether it's a test, whether you have to study vocab or read like 45 chapters or whatever it is, you always have to be in that right state of mind, a really positive mentality, and just grind through that work. You also have to be very mentally aware of exactly what you're working on, or else you're just wasting your time. I know everyone's had that experience of you're reading through a chapter of your textbook and you get through a paragraph and you're like, crap, I have no idea what I just read. Like, you just weren't processing it. So being in that focused mentality and being aware of exactly what you're reading, what you're studying, and taking notes along the way are some really helpful tips to just maximize your time, because especially in college or in high school where you have multiple courses, where you have midterms, you can't just be spending all your time studying for one. You have two or three or even four midterms you have to study for. So time efficiency and time management is crucial, especially when it comes to studying for a lot of these exams. And the hardest part is that you're covering so much information in such a short amount of time. You have to figure out, first off, what's important, as in what material you think your professor is going to cover the most, or what's the most relevant to your class, and then how are you going to condense that all into a cohesive study guide or vocab list or Quizlet or whatever it is that you need to study for. Another thing that really helps me is turning off all your distractions. Even though I'm not the very best at this, turning off your phone, turning off your laptop, getting away from your friends, because as fun as it is to study with your friends or go on Twitter after reading a few chapters, it can end up being distracting just having that technology there. So what I like to do is just put it in your backpack, don't get it out until you have a nice study break, which kind of leads me to, you know, blocking out your time. For me, I think the most efficient amount of time that I can like really focus is maybe like 30 minutes, 45 minutes. And then after that, your brain just gets tired, which is why I don't always recommend like studying for 2 hours nonstop. Definitely take breaks in between, stand up, stretch, eat some food, check social media, and then, you know, just get back to hitting those books, because I'm sure there's tons of research. And like, what's worked for me personally is intensely focusing for short periods of time and then taking breaks in between so that your brain can really remember the information and retain that before your test. So yeah, that kind of leads me to my next point of having a game plan and splitting your work into manageable chunks. If I have an exam coming up, I like to count the days before and then assign a specific amount of work that I'm going to do each day before. So maybe I'll read 3 chapters this day, study 20 vocab words, and then write a paragraph of the essay. If you start blocking out your work throughout the week before a big deadline is coming up, then you're gonna be a lot less stressed, and then your work is already like partially finished, so you don't have to worry about cramming it all at one time at the end, which is really stressful, and I hate doing that. I hate when there's a deadline and I don't have most of my work done, which is why it's just so much easier and more convenient to, you know, be prepared along the way so that no roadblocks come up and you're screwed. You know what I mean? So I'm sure most of you guys clicked on this video because you're wondering how I study at Princeton, blah, blah, blah. And you know, is it hard? Are the classes really that academically rigorous? And to be completely honest, yeah. Like yes, they're hard, they're stressful, there's a lot of work. And some days you really just wanna give up. But that's not to say that end of the day, you know, the Princeton and an Ivy League education isn't worth it. And so if you're really looking into trying to get into one of these Ivy League schools, I definitely recommend checking out the sponsor of today's video, Crimson Education. They're a college consulting firm. They help with SAT, ACT, essay writing, a bunch of different packages that help students get into their dream level schools, a lot of Ivy Leagues. I personally didn't use any college consulting firm. I did go to SAT and ACT prep back home, but I didn't use any online service. But to be honest, if I did know this service, I would definitely be interested. It's just so much easier having a coach every step of the way to guide you through the process, especially if you're a first timer and don't know what the college application process is like, or you're not the best essay writer, or you're not the best test taker. Crimson Education just has a lot of resources and tools to help you do the best you can. If you're interested, I'll have them linked down below. Make sure you guys fill out the form and they'll send you a bunch of information. So another big thing is organizing your notes beforehand, especially when you're taking notes throughout your class. Sometimes they can be messy, they can be disorganized, but what I found helps is if you organize as you go, then when you get to the end of the semester, you have a really nice study guide laid out that you don't have to spend time going through and organizing to make sure it looks good before you get down to studying it. If you color code it or organize it by sections or just have everything highlighted, it's just gonna make your life way easier when you get to getting ready to study for your exams. Another huge thing is getting enough hours of sleep. I've emphasized this in a few of my other videos, but I always like getting at least 8 hours of sleep. If not, I'm just way too tired for my classes. I'm groggy, I fall asleep, and then that's just counterproductive to me learning anything in them. So just making sure you get a full night's rest. There's no point in trying to cram the night before a test. So this morning I had my sociology exam at 9 a.m. and I went to bed by 1 last night. That last hour before bed, I just did a brief overview of all of my notes, making sure I knew all the key topics, looking up anything I was unsure about. And I woke up this morning with a full 8 hours of sleep, got a nice breakfast in, walked to my class, and I killed that test this morning. I'm feeling really confident about it. And if I hadn't done all the steps that I've mentioned throughout this video, I probably wouldn't have done as well. So that just goes to show that, you know, these studying tips are really effective, at least for me, and I hope that they can be applicable to you. So yeah, midterms are finally done. I'm going to New York tomorrow and then back home to Dallas the next few days. So super glad that this half of the semester is over. I don't have any more footage to make this longer, but I have vlog footage from a few days ago that I'm gonna just put in right now.